and girls, children of all ages, D-Generation X proudly presents to you the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions of the World, the Road Dogg Jesse James, the Badass Billy Gunn, the New Age Outlaws, and if you don't like it, we got two words for you. Y'all know what those words are, man. Put it down in the comments, man. But anyway, for all of my gym stars, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy, J-Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK, the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video, man. And like I said, we're going to try to make these videos be significantly shorter, and we're just going to get right to the news and right into everything. So without further ado, cue the Dre, man. Alright, so if you guys didn't know, Chalk DF, he is Chalk DF, he has become the world's first Elite 2. He has a video up about it. He's showing you some of the things, some of the rewards here, some of the animation. That was a sick animation that it starts out with and all that good stuff. So make sure you go check that video out. I watched it. I thought it was pretty cool. I think some of the rewards are underrated. And I really feel like if you want to grind that far, like, one of the rewards is being able to make your own t-shirt. Being able to make your own t-shirt, bro. Don't you know we gonna have Gym Star t-shirt? You can't sell it at the kiosk because they messed it up in 2K18, but I really wish that we could do that. But having the Gym Star t-shirt would have been so cool. We could have had all the Gym Stars with the Gym Star t-shirt on, and we could have shown allegiance. But it's all good. We got some real life t-shirts for you guys and all that, so you don't have to worry about that. Like I said, those should be up in the shop today if I'm able to do the things that I want to do today. I haven't been able to do some of the things to get my shop because I've been having so much work to do for other people. Like, I print t-shirts for a lot of other people as well, so that's where that's been going. But anyway, on to the next segment. NBA 2K Lab has put together a fantastic video on the effects of Steady Shooter. The badge seems to be a decent badge. They break down how it affects your open shot as well as how it impacts your shot when you shoot it. The long and the short of it is, they say it's only gonna give you about a 12% increase on Hall of Fame, and you only take about a 5% hit if you don't have if you have the badge on at all. So on your open shots, it's a 5% hit that you're gonna take, but it adds a 12% boost to shots that are contested. So you're gonna hit 12% more shots if somebody's right there in your face, but at the same time, if you're wide open, you're gonna miss 5% more shots. I don't know if the trade-off is worth it, but their recommendation is, if you wanna see what their recommendation is, make sure you hit up the video in the description. You will be able to see it, and they're gonna go way in more in depth with it than I was able to, and it's gonna be a good time. Hey, what it do, Cap? Hey, check it out. Your boy Zach Timmerman felt like he had to call out Mike Wong on Twitter. Mike Wong, as you may have seen the other day when he was talking to your boy EJ was asking Mike Wong how tall he is. Mike says he's 5'11 and he can dunk. Your boy Zach Timmerman just blew the entire top off the whole situation. He says, false, he can dunk a chicken tender like no other, and I seen it today. Hashtag Chipotle Mayo. Bro, what kind of, I don't know what you would call this, bro. I don't know if you would call this hate, if it's just calling Mike on his cap, or what you think about it, Cap? We got my homeboy Cap Calloway here. I don't know if you call it exposure, whatever. He's really exposed his boy on that, man. Hey, look, man, if my man is 5'11 and he says he can dunk, you gotta let the man believe that he can still get up them old legs or whatever, man. But hey, it is what it is. He blew the top off the situation and exposed my guy. I don't know how I feel about that. Y'all let me know how y'all feel about it down in the comments below. Do you think Mike can dunk, or do you think it's all cap? Put "it's all cap" down in the comments if you think Mike Wong don't got hots. And last but not least, my boy Flight White. And first of all, a lot of you guys don't know that I know Flight on a personal level. Back in 2009, 2010, I knew Flight before Flight was Flight. And he actually told some people that weren't aware of it. We used to play Modern Warfare together. I used to be kind of a big deal on YouTube and Twitch. Like all the, 2, 3, 500,000 views. I used to get all this stuff, man, but then I stopped because I had my little boy and all of that. Which segues me, Yodman. Listen, brother, I want to tell you this. I just want to send a special message out to you. I know you said that you're getting ready to have a baby. Your wife is having a few complications and all that. This is all on Yodman's story or what have you. Man, listen, whatever you got to do, take care of what you have to take care of at home, but make sure you keep pumping out the YouTube videos. I know that you probably don't need the money and that you probably don't, none of that stuff really matters. But as far as a future and where your channel is trending, the amount of money that you can make off YouTube can set you up for life, my guy. Look, as a person that had all that at their feet, my wife had a little boy, he had complications, and we still have to deal with stuff like that to this day. There's nothing that I could do about it. So if I had it to do all over again, I'd still take care of her. But I would just pump out the YouTube videos as much as I can. Try to get at least 3 out a week. And then, you know, do what you gotta do. But the channel is growing. And one thing about YouTube is you don't always get a chance to come back. Like I said, when I left, I think I had like 40,000 subscribers. Now I'm at 75,000. I never have been able. I'm talking about 40,000 in a matter of a few months, and then I'm at 75,000 now, like 8 years later. So you don't know if you'll ever be able to re-seize that momentum. But do what you got to do. Take care of your family, but also know that momentum, you may not be able to grab it again. So do what you can. Throw the videos out there when you can. Just don't quit, my guy. Good luck to you. Godspeed. And that's all we really have for you guys today, man. Look, I think I enjoy doing these shorter segments and all that, just giving you guys quick updates on stuff, talking about some of the things that are going on in the community. And I get to actually edit these videos and all that good stuff. You guys, let me know what you think about it. If you didn't know, like I said, Flight White, he played annoying again last night. It was number 3. If you want to see the outcome of that, Flight won the first game, and then it was a best of 5. Flight won the first game. They lost the last 3. He felt like he got sold by one of his homeboys. If you want to see which one of those homeboys he feels like he got sold by, make sure you go to Flight's channel. Link is down in the description and all that good stuff. And we're going to holler at y'all next time. Till next time, it's your boy Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Holla! 360 out this month.